Inquisitor!
What happened here?
The House of Repose decided to pay a visit. The guards arrived in time, but I should have guessed the assassins would infiltrate the servants.
Are you sure they didn't hurt you?
They only frightened me. It was all so sudden. Leliana assigned people to shadow me. They appear to have saved my life. I owe you everything, Sergeant.
Only my duty, Ambassador. I'll talk with the Spymaster about these murderous louts. She'll find how they got in.
Any news on the House of Repose, Inquisitor?
What's the next favor we need to get these Duparakets a lordship?
We need a judge of the Royal Court to procure documents acknowledging them as nobility again.
You read the report?
It was unusual. Is he always so blunt?
Yes.
Let's see what we have.
Any news on rifts beyond reach of the Inquisition?
Yes. And it is not good.
The city has agreed to send us 5 dozen guardsmen.
Not raw recruits. With luck, they'll know which end to grip a sword by.
Any news on the House of Repose, Inquisitor?
What's the next favor we need to get these Duparakets a lordship?
We must persuade Minister Belize to ratify the papers. She's in charge of these matters of rank. The Minister will be at a small fete thrown by the Marquis Wiscott. I'll get you an invitation. Let us begin. My scouts report no signs of danger in the pass nearby.
I will arrange patrols to ensure it stays that way.
We smuggled the other memory crystal into Calpurnia's camp.
We have. Here.
Ugh. Even honey can't sweeten Philandris. I'll keep trying. You are no slave, Linnea. I'll add another spoonful myself later.
Calpurnia seems to be treating her new acolytes kindly.
While I found that interesting, this is what you must hear.
Master, forgive me. I didn't expect.
The time for your ascension nears. Tell me of your preparation.
They go well enough, although I'm distracted here. If I could train at the shrine.
Only Dumont's faithful may enter. Continue as before. Or would you see the Imperium's rebirth stalled by your lack of focus?
I will be ready, as the vessel, and Tevinter's champion.
Calpurnia sounds like she's doing this for Tevinter, not Corypheus.
Another deflection. Why, a dwarven bauble, as if mine was miraculously returned to me. Let's give your new owner a glimpse of his fate. Venatori, we leave!
That is all the crystal recorded before she found it. But I think it may be enough. A shrine to Dumat, Corypheus said. Where Calpurnia is forbidden to go.
Who is this Dumat that Corypheus mentioned?
An old god, worshipped in ancient Tevinter as the Dragon of Silence. He was the first to rise as an archdemon and bring the Blight. Truly a god fit for Corypheus.
I'd bet Corypheus has something in that shrine he doesn't want Calpurnia to see.
I agree. There is much to gain here. Whatever Corypheus hides from his trusted lieutenant should be illuminating. Let us investigate this shrine carefully. I doubt Corypheus has left it unguarded.
Something is troubling me, Inquisitor. Leliana is receiving reports of mages becoming possessed. Templars going rogue. No one is dealing with these matters. I was hoping we might, before they get worse.
We can certainly look into it.
I will mark these incidents on the map as I learn of them, Inquisitor. And I would be pleased to accompany you if and when you investigate.
That's enough for now.
Another time, then.
This is just... it's something to keep their hands busy. I'm grateful you tracked me down when you did. As exciting as wandering the woodlands was, this is better. It's good to be part of something so important. Something that could change things.
I'm pleased that you feel that way.
Makes me sound like a Chantry sister, doesn't it? Some giddy new initiate. But so be it. I suppose you've earned my loyalty. And girlish enthusiasm. You are who you choose to follow. Someone told me that once. Took me years to understand what he meant.
There's wisdom in that.
It was a chevalier who said those words to me. A powerful man, but never without honor. A true knight. We met as competitors in the Grand Tourney. He left me with that advice before we parted. Put aside his own ambitions to help me win the melee. I don't think I even thanked him.
That was generous of him.
He said I stood to gain everything, while he'd lose nothing. When it was over, he offered to mentor me, to teach me to become a chevalier like him. And I, young and stupid, turned him down flat. I just won the melee at the Grand Tourney. I didn't need him. I should have gone with him. Perhaps things could have been different.
You're here now, a Grey Warden. It worked out.
I suppose it did, didn't it? But I'm older, hopefully wiser, and I think I've chosen the right person to walk with.
As leader of the Inquisition, you... there's something I must tell you.
Whatever it is, I'm willing to listen.
Right. Thank you. Lyrium grants Templars our abilities, but it controls us as well. Those cut off suffer. Some go mad, others die. We have secured a reliable source of Lyrium for the Templars here. But I... no longer take it.
You stopped?
When I joined the Inquisition. It's been months now.
Cullen, if this can kill you...
It hasn't yet. After what happened in Kirkwall, I couldn't. I will not be bound to the Order or that life any longer. Whatever the suffering, I accept it. But I would not put the Inquisition at risk. I've asked Cassandra to watch me. If my ability to lead is compromised, I will be relieved from duty.
Thank you for telling me. I respect what you're doing.
Thank you, Inquisitor. The Inquisition's army must always take priority. Should anything happen, I will defer to Cassandra's judgment.
You're doing good work, boss. I like how this Inquisition is coming. Next time you're free, why don't you come grab a drink? I'll introduce you to the Chargers.
You said we should go get some drinks and meet your company.
Yeah, come on. It'll be fun. Ah, good. We're not drinking alone. How you doing, creme de la creme?
Your worship, I'm so glad he has someone new to hit with that joke.
Do you prefer creme or cremisius?
Creme's faster. The chief's nicknames usually end up sticking.
Hey, when I was growing up, my name was just this series of numbers. We all give each other nicknames under the cune.
They ever wear shirts under the cune, chief? Or do they just run around binding their breasts like that?
It's a harness, creme.
Yes, for your pillowy man bosoms. Let me know if you need help binding. You could really chisel something out of that overstuffed look.
Who were the others?
A lot of the Chargers went looking off for stronger drinks. Let's see, who's left? We've got Rocky and Skinner there. And over there are Stitches, Dalish, and Grim. Crazy bunch of assholes, but they're mine.
So, how do you join the Chargers?
Killed some people.
Skinner didn't take kindly to nobles testing their new swords on the elves in her alienage.
Bull took me in. Now I get paid to kill shams.
This is actually really good behavior for her. She's not marking her territory or anything.
Grim, is it?
Grim doesn't talk much. I'm pretty sure he's the lost king of some small country, or a chieftain, something like that.
Were you born on the surface, or are you from Orzammar?
Orzammar. I got exiled. Stupid noble crap. Also, I accidentally blew up a bit of the shape rate.
Rocky's one of our best sappers. He can take down enemy fortifications faster than a golem.
I'm also working on my own version of Kunari black powder. I've almost got it.
Yeah, you really don't.
Why aren't you with your clan?
Our keeper thought I should see the world a little.
Dalish don't have Templars, so they can't have too many mages in a clan at once.
Now, sir, you know I'm not a mage. That'd make me an apostate.
You carry a staff, Dalish.
It's a bow.
A bow with a giant glowing crystal at the tip.
Yes, it's for aiming. Old elven trick you wouldn't understand.
I take it you're the company healer.
Yes, first time I ever picked up a sword was when the blight hit Ferelden. Never put it back down.
He makes a potion that'll put you right back on your feet after even the toughest fight. It tastes terrible, though.
That's because it's a poultice, sir. You're not supposed to drink it.
You've got a good company, Bull.
Ah, we do all right.
No man can beat the Chargers, cause we'll hit you where it hurts. Unless you know a tavern with loose cards and loose skirts. For every bloody battlefield, we'll gladly raise a cup. No matter what tomorrow holds, our horns be pointing up!
Thanks for coming by, boss. Glad you could meet some of my team.
So he's able to conscript at will, I suppose.
Don't worry about that. They only take the exceptional. Joey, not the butler.
Back. He hates it all because of the darkness behind the door. Some doors should stay shut.
Can you explain how your mind works?
Yes.
It must be sad, feeling everyone's pain all the time.
Why?
Isn't it?
No. I help. I find wounds and heal them. I salve, soothe, save. I see pain and make it better. How could I not be happy?
Walk me through the way you help someone.
I start by listening. I hear hurt, feel it fretting. Some you can solve by giving something, food, a blanket, sleep. Some are intangible, terrible tangles that catch on a crack, fixed, festering, and the person makes a pearl of pain. I shake it loose. No pearl, no pain. They can hope, they can heal.
What do you sense when you focus on me?
You're too bright. Like counting birds against the sun. The mark makes you more, but past it, you reach across. Mindful, meaning. You pull it through to this side, make it real here. And past that, the weight of all on you. All the hopes you carry, fears you fight, you are theirs. It must be very hard. I hope I help.
Sometimes you say things that relate to other members of the Inquisition.
They remember me. Their eyes stick, some more. They want me to be. Varric is quiet inside. He pulls me more to hear. Makes me a person. Calls me kid. A friend. Solace, bright and sad. Observes and accepts. Spirit self, seeing the soul, solace. But somehow, sorrows.
I'll talk to you later.
How do you know?
Demon armies and wardens, and Varric has exactly who we need. The big talker just knows everything.
Is your network of contacts still active after what happened?
After Lord Arsehole and Vichel? Of course. He may have killed people, but that just means there's more who hate him. It's crap that he killed people, though. They were just trying to stand up a little.
Is Red Jenny real? Or was she always just you and your friends?
Dunno.
Don't you care?
Not if it works. I mean, Red is scary because... blood. And Jenny is... look, nobody fears the bunch of people who do random stuff. And besides, it's easy. Nobles want a bogeyman because they need to believe normal people can't get at them. Numbers, right? It don't have to be so complicated.
So do you take turns leading or something like that?
There's nothing to lead. Put a few favors in, take a few out. Stop and you cut yourself out. Other than that, we stay out of each other's way. Probably best. Some are right asses.
We'll talk another time.
It's all good, innit?
Sir Lordy Bloomers.
You have any worries about how my magic is developing?
Really? You have to ask what's so bad about the magic stuff. I mean, that weirdy talking about night-whatevers.
Night Enchanter. Battle magic.
Not helping. I don't understand that stuff. It's scary to anyone smart enough to think for a second. You shouldn't be scary. You're the Inquisitor.
Don't be silly. I'm not that scary.
Oh, ha ha, real funny. Fine, I'm fine with it. Be scary and a shit.
Are things playing out the way you expected?
Cassandra laid it out, right? You're the big hat now. Gonna make everything the way it should be. Praying's nice, I suppose. Corypheus bit, though. Shite.
Corypheus.
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 Sack splash. I know his name. Doesn't deserve the respect of me saying it, does he?
I'll be back if I need you.
Go on.
Really? You did not notice? I had no idea Lady Beverly was one of your people. You might have told me before I embarrassed myself. At your service.
thank you for seeing me in private, Minister Belize.
I chastise you for taking me from the party, Inquisitor, but the Marquis throws such dull affairs, it's hardly worth it. I assume you wish to discuss your petition to elevate these Duparaquettes to a minor lordship. Tell me, why should I allow you to pollute the Orlesian nobility any further than it's already been muddled?
The Duparaquettes used to be noble. You'd be restoring an old house of Orlais.
Restoring it far too late. What are the Duparaquettes now? Traders? Farmers? Really, it is too much. The very thought causes me pain. What can you possibly provide that will make your petition worth my effort?
I don't think we'll be missed from the party for a while.
Are you quite serious?
For the pleasure of your company, Minister. Absolutely.
Lock the door. And fetch me some pillows.
Is this a bad time? I can come back.
No, it's all right. Bills are really not that engrossing. I've been meaning to come talk to you anyhow. I never officially joined the Inquisition. I don't know how to do this disciplehood thing. I'm a businessman. Never really followed a chosen one before.
I don't need a disciple. I need a friend.
If you knew how intimidating you are, you wouldn't make it sound so simple. You just don't know what you are to the people out there. The Herald of Andraste is a symbol bigger than any of us.
What am I to you, then?
None of this shit makes any sense to me. Is this the end of the world? Did Andraste send you through the breach? I have no idea. You heard the crowd singing after Haven was attacked?
Whatever I am to Thedas, I'm still just an ordinary person.
So, just a regular person, like anybody else. Right. I should probably get back to work, unless, you up for a game of Wicked Grace?
Lost three shipments.
I must return to Valrayo to see that everything is in order. Please join me when you can.
Referential parlay. Experiences that are new, but safe.
My path was right all along. I was merely insufferable.
And then...
I received a letter from the House of Repose, Your Worship. They acknowledge their contract is null and void. There is no longer a price on my life.
I'm glad you don't have to live your life looking over your shoulder anymore.
I regret we were forced to deal with them. That you were endangered by my part in the game. Did I ever mention I used to be a bard?
You were a singer.
Bards entertain the Orlesian court. They sing, play music, make charming conversation, and spy. Many young nobles put on a mask and practice playing the game in such a fashion.
What made you interested in becoming a bard?
I was attending a university in Valroyo when I learned about bards. There was such an air of romance about them. Stories of secrets, trysts, and fascinating people. A group of us, young gentry from Antiva, decided this exciting life was for us.
You seem a bit steady for such an outgoing lifestyle.
The life of an entertainer didn't suit me at all. During one particular intrigue, I encountered a bard sent to kill my patron. We fought, or perhaps scrapped. Is the better word. Both of us terrified. We were at the top of a steep flight of stairs. The other bard threw a knife, and I pushed him away from me. You can imagine the result.
You were only defending yourself.
But it was such a waste, Inquisitor. When I took off his mask, I knew him. We'd attended parties together. If I'd stopped to reason, if I'd used my voice instead of scuffling like a common thug, I'll always wonder who that young man would have grown into.
He seemed willing enough to murder you for the game.
Perhaps. I feel I'm the last to judge whether or not he would have actually used the blade. In all the commotion... forgive me, I don't believe I ever thanked you for helping me with this.
I'd do it again in a heartbeat. Such a gracious woman deserves nothing less.
Such talk. I'm quite overcome.
Should I stop?
Oh, no. I mean, yes. I meant... no, I don't... Well, if you meant to draw a blush to my cheeks, you've completely succeeded. Let's return to Skyhold before anyone notices.
Nothing to report, sir.
After more than 30 days, I have yet to observe the Abyssal High Dragon in... Oh. Yes? Can I assist you?
My people have translated that to Vinter manuscript.
Studies on dragon hunting patterns? Migrations? Ha! Durant's theory that dragons can't see the color blue is refuted. With those dreadful raiders out of the way, we can finally lure out the Abyssal High Dragon. You should have the honor, my friend. I've made note of the appropriate spots in the wastes for you to place lures. Place this bait, and then... wait. It will be a momentous achievement in draconology.
I'm off to plant the bait for the High Dragon.
I cannot wait to hear your observations. You must make note of how she circles the hunting area.
We'll have to speak some other time.
Boss, I want you to know, you're the best.
A dragon. Let's be sure she leaves us in one piece.
to report some.
Of course, Durin's theory of high dragon behavior is absurd, but... Oh, yes? Did you need something?
The high dragon attacked me when I planted the bait. I'm afraid it's dead.
She attacked? How wonderful! You had a first-hand view of her behavior. Did you take any notes on her aggressive posturing? I suppose you wouldn't have. No matter. I should very much like to interview you. At a later time, of course. I could join your Inquisition. My expertise could be of use, and your scouts could help me find other specimens.
Certainly. I'm sure the Inquisition could use a draconologist.
Excellent. I'm sure my research will be of great use to you.
Recruits. Who can tell me?
Don't you?
Finish gears here. Except.
Did you see those Venatori run? this?
The Darkspawn got through. I'll have to see what our people at Skyhold can do.
Inquisitor?
At your order.
Leliana wished to speak with you, Inquisitor. It seemed rather urgent. Yes?
Let's speak later.
Another time.
Have you had any trouble with them?
Not at all. I will inform you if that changes.
So this is the shrine Corypheus hid from Calpurnia.
It is far, far too quiet.
A shrine to one of the old gods. Few still exist.
Shrines are bad. Who here doesn't know that?
in a world twisted into perversion and ruin, awake only to discover the light.
Some more memory crystals. Corypheus was recording his thoughts.
See what manner of herald this age has bred. I recited the old verses. How easily they come even after so long a slumber. Yet still I do not feel the presence of Dumont. Hear no whispers, no commands. Silence has fallen.
That's a spell of containment, a powerful one.
What is this? Who are you?
Magister Erasthenes, am I a scholar of Timinter? To Corypheus, I am bound to answer every question. Gersenius, I am lost.
Corypheus did this to you, on Calpurnia's behalf.
She knows not a thought. I am a ruin, the jeweled husk when the butterfly leaves. I was the greatest scholar of the old gods in Minrathus. No, in the Imperium. One night, he came to my door. For my relics, I thought, my writings. Runes. But instead, my slave went to his side, Calpurnia, to become the vessel and save Tivinta.
If Calpurnia's this vessel, what are the contents going to be?
I do not know. Power. It must be some sort of power. Power like Ethemiel's, risen in flame.
Is that why Calpurnia joined Corypheus? To save your empire?
Yes, she seeks a leader, Corypheus, to shape Tevinter's rebirth. She would raise up the slaves as she was raised. Bring a new order with a heart of steel. She could do it if she were not the vessel.
If Calpurnia is the one Corypheus wanted, why do this to you?
For practice. I, Corypheus, crafts a vessel for whatever power he seeks. Yes. He does not need his vessel to have free will. About her, these same chains will fall. Iron to cage lightning. My binding is the poor pencil sketch. Calpurnia will be the masterpiece.
She'd reconsider being Corypheus's pet magister if she found out.
Hers is a cold rage to rival the wrath of Corypheus. This chain has broken me, friend. No wings can raise my mind. Please, breach the circle.
Its wards will trigger. I will be dust and light. Free.
Or it will kill us. Corypheus is not above placing such a trap.
Corypheus' circle will hold its destruction within. Tight. Tight. No fear. Only freedom.
All right. You seem honest. And you've suffered enough.
Light a lamp, would you, Calpurnia? Everything's dark.
Calpurnia prepares to set foot in the place where regret dwells, to bring it into the light. She cannot know what must be done, cannot understand. In time, she will forgive.
The reports from our agents at the shrine are intriguing. You were correct. Once Calpurnia becomes the vessel, she will lose her freedom. Forgive me, but I wish you hadn't been so quick to throw the enspelled Magister away.
Erasthenes was suffering. He'd already told me everything.
We can never be certain now. Corypheus's notes mention a place where regret dwells. That is more of a mystery. Until the notes are deciphered, I intend rumors of the binding ritual to reach Calpurnia's ears.
Why waste time with rumors? Warn her.
We are the enemy, Inquisitor. She suspects Corypheus, but she knows we work against her. Breaching his sanctum might give Corypheus pause, yet Calpurnia is silent, as are her agents. We have given her something to think about.
Inquisitor, may I have a word? I notice you've paid Lady Montelier quite a number of compliments.
Yes, I enjoy her company very much.
An entanglement with our ambassador seems most unwise. I asked Josephine to join the Inquisition because we needed a diplomat, not so she could be toyed with.
I enjoy being with Josephine. I'm not trying to break her heart.
Then I would be more cautious. Josephine's no stranger to courtly intrigue. But love? There she's an innocent. She has no idea you are truly attracted to her. If indeed you are.
Yes. I'm very attracted to Josephine.
Is that so? Whatever is between you, I ask that you treat her with kindness, for her sake, as well as yours.
Whatever happens, I'm glad to see Josephine has a concerned friend here.
I have so few true friends these days. Those that are left, I deeply cherish. I will not trouble you any further, but I do watch over my friends. Good day, your worship. You've joined a fellowship with a distinguished history. Night enchanters have long served the divine.
Alas, we're lacking one at the moment.
Indeed.
Sorry.
It's all right. I was thinking it even as you said it. No matter, you have chosen well, and are in good company. I had friends who were night enchanters, who served at Justinia's side, who died with her. It's good to see new mages keeping this flame alive.
Let's talk about you.
Me?
What did you do before you worked for the Divine?
I was a bard, an Orlesian spy for many years. For a time, I also served a small cloister in Lothering. After the Blight, the Divine called on me to oversee her personal network.
Can you teach me to be a bard?
Being a bard is so much more than being a spy. It involves a keen understanding of politics, the ebb and flow of influence, the great game. The bard's is an intricate dance where a smile can be sharper than any dagger. The best way to learn is to immerse yourself in it. Perhaps when this is all over, I'll teach you.
Bards tell tales. I bet you tell some good ones.
There are plenty of tales in the library. Perhaps you should look for them there.
I should leave you to your work.
We can always talk later.
To me that you're a mage.
That just occurred to you.
I meant, you must have been part of the circle of magi in the south. Meaning, you were locked away like a criminal, at least until you rebelled. It's such a bizarre notion to me.
Why do you think we rebelled?
A lack of civilized entertainment, clearly. I've been to your southern taverns. It's more surprising that everyone would take the idea of a mage inquisitor so calmly. Maybe it's not calm. Maybe the Antivan crows are swimming in gold from all the contracts on your life. Good luck with that, by the way. Grand fun being the one in charge.
It occurs to me that I barely know anything about you.
I am the scion of House Parvus, a product of generations of careful breeding and the repository of its hopes and dreams. Naturally, I despised it all. The lies, the scheming, the illusions of supremacy. That's Tevinter in a nutshell, isn't it? Needless to say, my family was not happy with my choices.
I think I've heard enough.
That's too bad. I never tire of talking about myself.
I'd like to ask you about Tevinter.
Ah, yes. Everyone outside the Imperium always seems quite fascinated by it. Probably why they come up with so many ridiculous tales. Flying cows over Minrathus. That's madness. All right, that one's actually true, but the cows didn't have wings. I digress. anything in particular you wanted to know?
I'm wondering if the Imperium would be a useful ally.
I'd think you'd be more concerned whether or not they'd support the Venatori. They won't, of course. At least, not officially. They'll disavow all knowledge of dangerous cultists. Secretly, many Magisters will rejoice at the idea. And if the South falls to chaos in the meantime, all the better.
It would be in the Imperium's best interest to help. Surely it could use allies.
I think the Imperium gave up on the idea of allies a long time ago. We've been fighting the Canari for what? 200 years off and on? It's a point of pride that we go it alone. They'll sneer at the South behind their silk handkerchiefs and say, "You've had it easy for far too long." Let's not forget that the Inquisition seems to be an arm of the Orlesian Chantry. Anathema so far as they're concerned.
We're not part of the Chantry. The Chantry opposed the Inquisition's formation.
You think that matters? Don't be silly. The Herald of Andraste. Your very title smacks of the Southern Chantry. You may as well be a heathen. I think they're far more frightened what you'll do if you succeed.
That's all I wanted to know.
Fair enough.
I should go.
Try not to die. I would notice you were gone.
As I explored the Fade, I felt the presence of an intriguing artifact in the hinterlands. If you are willing, I would like to locate it. I have marked its location as best I could determine.
We'll talk later.
Goodbye.
good to have come out of the door. I don't have many goods here if you wish to trade.
According to my research, the ancient elves may have set up wards near here. If we can find the artifacts they used, it may help strengthen this area against tears.
Danger to you. My name is Maris. By your weapons, I see you come ready for battle. Perhaps we face a common enemy in these demons.
Are you fighting the demons on your own?
Fighting the demons is pointless. There will always be more, and I have no means of closing the rifts. But I have heard of elven artifacts that measure the veil. They may tell us where new rifts will appear. I was not expecting so many demons, however. I believe one of the artifacts is nearby. Can you help me reach it?
It sounds worth investigating.
Thank you. It shouldn't be too much farther ahead.
A war in the Fade, waged with human hate. I should never want to see that.
It would be a terrible thing. It would be a hybrid.
A child. It hurt her.
You
are to be the one with the words that wonder.
True.
Stop it.
Another of the elven artifacts.
Thank you for joining me. I do not think I could have done this alone.
How did you come to be here?
I was, first of Clan Venen. I left in service of my clan and saw that great tear in the veil on my journey. I know more of magic and the veil than any shaman, so I hope to help.
Maharal, darling.
We should keep moving.
Yes, the wards are helping to strengthen the veil. This area should be safer for travelers now.
Should react to the strength of the veil.
the ancestors left something for me as well. Interesting. I believe our alliance is concluded. Go and peace.
Mahalani, Maglandeva, the Anathali.
Aye. Perhaps you're right. Here, take it. Go with Mithal's blessing. Inquisitor. A rogue Templar! Sad that it came to this, but at least it is done.
Thank you.
what did Zerga
Well, Leliana just gave me quite the speech.
So long as the only... What about?
About us.
Oh, she is impossible. Might we discuss this somewhere more private? Leliana said I was an innocent in love?
More or less.
Of all the... I'm quite capable of understanding our association. I've never thought your intentions were overly romantic, Inquisitor, I assure you.
Perhaps I should have composed a ballad then, or sent roses.
What? You mean you do? We've only just... I didn't wish to presume you harbored any tender feelings for me.
I won't deny a certain captivation, Josephine.
But we haven't even known each other a few short months. How can you declare this liking for me after such a brief time together?
I've never met anyone whose presence affects me like you do. Perhaps it just means I'm a hopeless romantic, but there you have it.
I would not object to a closer relationship between us, my lord. If that sounds agreeable to you.
Nothing would make me happier.
Well, then.